had to do that. I had to do that. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. My name is Tina Fierce One, and let's delve in what's been happening in the week and, of course, some new details that have emerged in the world of celebrity gossip. My name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome. So, the whole Haruna Mubiru story that we did, and we're all like, yes, Haruna, why do you feel like you are very important? Abi, there were like 30 people who were all on those different platforms talking about how ill-mannered he is, how all of this. But then, you see, I always love to know two sides of the story, because the one side that I knew was the ladies on Mama Tendo and the chick in particular who was trying to hunt him down. But the thing, though, is that I didn't know which chick in particular we're talking about. Now, yesterday he did come through. He wanted to clarify and clear the air and give us his side of the story. And this one is entirely up to you, you know? I like to sit on fences. It's entirely up to you to decide if what he's saying is right or what she's saying is right. But according to him, he says this whole thing has just been blown out of proportion simply because he's not even the target for this woman's problems. I was like, wait, what? But it's you she brought the police for. It's you who she had recorded. Like, what are you saying that this is not even about you? So anyway, he broke it down for us. He says that this chick, is called Sumaya. Now, not only is she called Sumaya, apparently she is Jack Pemba's wife. You get the drift. Now, according to Haruna, he claims that she is after him not because of him or like work or anything. She is after him because she has a situation with Zari. Now, that's the part we're not understanding. Apparently, alikubanya abonya Haruna so that afune Zari. But how far stretched is this, though? How far? What do you think is going on here? Did Zari sleep with Jack Pemba?
Sumaya mchala wa Pemba, Jack Pemba chosora chiru mamu. Mukwano gwange yali mukwano gwange before simanyi kikyatwawula naye nga yali mukwano gwange namukolera baby shower ye bulungi nnyo era nga bulijjo nga nderivalinga ku WhatsApp ne mwa soft copies ze zonna baby shower negwa ey'omwana oyo birthday gye tubadde tuliko gye tuyomberamu nze siyomba naye gy'abadde tali mukakkamu nayo ne tumiitinga ne tukkanya ku ssente nga bw'omanyi ero gy'oli bw'oti naye olwokuba bakwano bo ne mujja nga mukkiriziganya ne tubaako essente ze twakkiriziganya egyali 80,000 kati ssente tebaazimperawo naye baŋŋamba zijja kujja mu time kati tuba tetunatandika kukola babula ng'aleeta akasente ke twali twalaganyeko before 80,000 3 days after ne tugenda ne tukola ki ne tudelivalinga omukolo na delivalinga soft copy yonna eri ebifaananyi 2 even if you check all her Instagram handles and Facebook kwebiri saagala kwogera ku mukwano gwange naye era sijja kwogera kumwogerako kuba bino ebintu bika byamaziga omuntu akukyawula okuba olina omuntu gw'okolera ebyo si birungi nze ndi musajja temumanyi background yange tojja kuva eri onkyawa olw'okuba nkolera Zari I didn't do fraud. Omuntu omutegeeva akiyita owning money by false pretense. But this was not owning money by false pretense. I did the job, I delivered a certain part of the work, I was remaining with a certain part of the work, I didn't manage to produce it because it accidentally got lost. Okitegeera. It was the client to understand. Okitegeera. Because nze namugamba ngenda ku deliveringa, ngenda mu refundinga sente ze.
Finally got to see Mastula Cafero's new bam bam. Woo child! I think a couple of months, I think it was at the beginning of this year or at the end of last year, when the news went viral, she had gone to Dr. Good. He is a very qualified surgeon. Like, he does all the plastic for all the top-notch people in Hollywood. And she had checked into his office to get herself silicone implants for her butt. Now, we all waited to see that silicone implant. Jesus, did we wait. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, you have not to wait any longer. Yes, girl is walking around. Her badonkadonk is filled with saline. Yay! We've seen the new butt. But you people, I don't get it. I don't. I'm trying to understand how broken these women are. How broken are you to not love yourself enough the way that you are? Like, why do we feel as women we always have to enhance what we look like? Honey girl, you are a gem in whatever shape size you come in. There's going to be someone for you always. If handicapped people have love, if people who don't have limbs and eyes have love, what? But in other news, yes, the men don't care whether it's silicone or if it's real. They finna smack that. So, congrats to her. She got herself a new wonders never cease to amaze. Y'all know that Keko left the country, right? Like, she was like, you know what? I'm a fly the coop. I cannot take this nonsense. I'm being witch hunted and head hunted and all those things. So she went to Canada. She's in Canada. So today morning, someone sends me an image of Keko. And I... Okay, Keko, you are a beautiful girl. I have to say this. You were a gorgeous girl. You were a gorgeous girl who was extremely talented. But then I also understand you didn't know how to deal with the negativity around you. So you thought by running away, it would fix it. No, it doesn't fix it. You are a beautiful girl. You are. Until I saw this image, I was like, wait, what? Who? But nice. Again, I don't want to be hateful, but just look at this image and tell me what you see. Now, you know that song that every Ugandan loved? Katuchi, got it. Eddie Awe and Karohu Nantongo. That song was such a hit. It has been played on almost every kwandula, almost every wedding. It was such a hit. Now, at the Charenga concert, Eddie Awe was on stage, and that's when he had to sing it with that idiot of a woman that she got, that lumpen, that... blah, blah. I'm looking for vile words that I can use on TV. Anyway, that chick who took off her skirt just because she wanted a minute of fame. So he's on stage and she's doing the song. But everybody knew that for a fact she is not Caro, the person that he sang the song with. So we wanted to delve and understand what's the situation, what's going on, until I found out the intricate details. Now, Caro Nantongo happens to be with Eagles. Is it the new Eagles? I don't know why they couldn't just write it in real English. Alimu bandage. Baina bi bandi bandi bi awe yokayola kasasido. Debazi kwasa ganya simanya. They are like Bloods and Crips only. Kilaka dongo kamu type. So anyway, she comes from one of them famous bands, right? So they claim that that when that song came out, Eddie Awe had already way too much clout. So they decided to tell the chick first. If you decide to sing this song with this guy, you're going to be overshadowed by Eddie Awe. How about you take a minute back and wait to grow your talent, and then we can move forward. I was like, wait, which band was that and who talked to her and how stupid were they? Do you know what it means to get a song, a hit song in Kampala? Do you know what it means to get a song that goes on kwandula, weddings, everything, even at a funeral you can sing it when they're putting the casket down, Katuchi, got it? It still falls. You get what I'm saying? Eddie claims the song is his. Caro, has Caro claimed the song is hers? She also claims the song is hers. But according to the sources that we reached out to, because we have just talked to King Saha, because we got word that that song originally, when Eddie wrote it, he wanted Juliana to be the one doing the chick's part. Juliana's schedule couldn't let her do that part, so he let Juliana slide. Then he got King Saha. King Saha says he laid a few of his, you know, like he did something, but it didn't come out quite the way he wanted. You have to understand, Eddie Awe is what we call, he's one of those people who likes to perfect. So he felt King Saha didn't lay right down with the beat properly, so he didn't give it to King Saha. So they kept looking for people to sit on that particular beat. And guess what? When Caro Nantongo came through, it was a perfect hit. But at the end of the day, I'm trying to get down to the bottom of it all. I just believe it's a beautiful song. And for a song that good, we need to understand why the two people who did it are not at the same wavelength. Why? Now, for all comments about this song, you let me know. But I personally believe that what Eddie is doing, to have someone else perform on the song, is a little bit too childish. Because I believe for a fact, but then again, if Caro wants to get most out of this song, she can do the same. She can decide to start performing it with different people. Isn't that allowed? Because both of them claim they have rights to the song. I was like, man, the drama. And before I can say my bye-byes, I had a rumor that Palazzo is looking at going back to work with Jeff Chiwa. I am actually going to say this. Let Palazzo get back to Jeff Chi. Well, it's been a minute. They work together. There's a way Jeff Chi brings out some beautifulness out of Palazzo, other than him being on Twitter and just being stupid and calling people names that he's not supposed to call. He's redundant. He needs a manager who is going to put him back on the map. I say, yay, Palazzo. Reach out. Reach out to Jeff Chi and beg, plead, because you don't have a career out here. Beg him. Who knows? Maybe we could get another collab between you and Sheba. I don't know. Collab emu inzo kutambuza miyake. Sato laba yedi jemwa kola. Yakutambuza miyake meka. Jachali konekati. It's been my time. I'm out. Catch you Monday. Peace.